Welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today we're going to talk about markings on heads. I'm going to teach you about the different markings and what they mean. But before we get started, please subscribe, like, share our videos, and hit the bell so you're notified when I come out with a new video. So let's get started. All right, I have a bunch of bolts here, and I just wanted to go through the markings on these bolts so you understand them when you read them. Some of the markings on here will indicate that is a grade 8, grade 5, grade 2, standard alloyed, 316 stainless, 18/8 stainless. So I'm going to show you a couple of heads. First, I'm going to show you this piece of paper here, which basically shows you the standard markings according to IFI requirements. And when you look at this, you can see that some bolts heads have absolutely no markings, and some have strikes on them. And then some have like a number and a letter on it, like a B7. So I'm gonna just go through this right now and show you a few heads with the markings and what they mean. Okay, so this here has no markings on it. Only marking that it does have is a manufacturer's marking. And how do you tell the difference? So typically you'll see initials on there. This is an LB. Okay, so that's a manufacturer's marking. Whereas if you took this one here, so no markings, that would be a standard grade 2 bolt, just for your information. On this one, we have three slashes, and typically three slashes is going to be grade 5. Okay, you see the JH there? That's a manufacturer's marking. So you have two different types of marks here. You have a manufacturer's mark, so if someone questions this bolt, should it fail, the manufacturer knows right away when he looks at it if it's his bolt. The three slashes that you see on this head, that indicates that it's a grade 5 bolt. This is a grade 8 bolt. Again, you see JDF on that bolt on the top, those initials. Those initials, again, are a manufacturer's marking to indicate that this is their bolt. And then you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 slashes indicates it's a grade 8. So if it had no manufacturer's marking, you would just see those 6 slashes, and that would indicate to you that you have a grade 8 bolt. And the reason why you're looking for these, so when you buy bolts, you want to make sure that you have the correct bolt for your application. So like in cars, you don't want to typically use a grade 2. Because depending on what it's for, suspension, tying in your front arms, that's not made for that. You typically want to go for a grade 5 or a grade 8, depending on what the manufacturer recommends. And that's, you know, just talking about different applications. This bolt here, which is a hot dip galvanized alloy bolt, it has, again, the manufacturer's markings, the XYLX, and then it says 307A. 307A is the indication of the strength of the bolt. Basically, this is equal to like a carriage bolt strength, a grade 2 or better, a little bit better than a grade 2, but standard alloyed. These are not heat treated. When you're dealing with grade 8, these are through and through heated bolts, so they're treated for strength, and grade 5 are partially treated. On to the next one. Again, you can see a THE at the bottom. This is a stainless bolt. You can see THE at the bottom. That's a manufacturer's mark. And you will see here S30400. That's a 304 stainless steel. That's what that's telling me. So when I read a stainless, stainless does not come with slashes. They come with an actual marking of the level of stainless. This one here, you'll see again the manufacturer's marking. ABF, I'm sorry, ABP, and then you'll see S304. The S stands for stainless, and the 30400 is the marking for stainless steel. And those markings that you're seeing on these bolts are standard to IFI recommendations, which standardizes this throughout the industry. And this one here, this is an S316, so this is a higher grade stainless steel. You can see here that it says S31600, and at the bottom you see the manufacturer's marking again, THE. That's the manufacturer that made the bolt. And the last one, this again is 316 stainless. In this situation, it also has another manufacturer's marking on it, F593H. And you can see that there. Then it has like a logo punched into the head. That again is a manufacturer's marking. So there you go. I just wanted to show you how to read these things so you understand them. So when you're looking at them, and a lot of you car guys want to grind these things off. But before you grind them off, know what you bought so you understand what's supposed to be in the box when you receive it. Thanks for watching. There you go. Subscribe, like, comment. Visit us at albanycountyfasteners.com for 50,000 SKUs right off the rack, ready to ship. We look forward to seeing you in our next video.